So here we have to expand once again, and here realize that whenever we have a quotient as the input of the main log, we will have to have a difference of individual inputs, the logs of the individual inputs, right? So basically what this means is that we're gonna have log base 6 x to the sixth power minus log base 6 of the product of the bottom, 216 z to the third. Okay, so now we know that the power comes down, right? So the 6 comes down, that power, and we just have log base 6 input x minus. So now we're going to use the product rule. The product rule for the expansion here in this case is going to be the sum of the logs of the individual inputs, right? So we have two inputs being multiplied. 216 is one input, z to the third is the second input, right? So we're going to have, and we're going to use a bracket because here we're going to have an addition result, right? So this minus will become a parent minus. That's why we have to have a bracket. Okay, so we're going to have log 6 of the first input, 216, plus, right, because they were talking about a sum when the inputs are multiplied, plus the log base 6 of the z to the third input, right? So that's that. So you see, if we hadn't applied the parent minus sign, then we would just have a wrong sign for the second one, right? But the minus sign will still apply to the second, right? Because there will have to be a minus sign in the end, minus log 6 z to the third, right? So it's very important that you use brackets, because if you want to apply the sum rule, this is a parent minus sign, right? Because you will have two terms derived as a result of using the sum rule. Okay, so let's keep expanding these and simplifying them as we go. So 6 log 6 base 6 input x minus log base 6 input 216 minus, right, the parent minus applies here as well, log, right, so I know that because it applies to that plus, right, that minus is carried over, right, so minus log 6 base 6 input z to the third. So now let's simplify this. So we can't do anything about the first one, but we can do something about the second one. Right, we know that we can express 216 with base 6 raised to the power of what? So 6 squared is 36. 36 times 6 is exactly 216. Right, so it's going to be to the third power. Minus. So now here we go. The power here will go down, right? So the 3 goes down, and we're going to have log base 6 z. Okay, so let's keep writing. So we're going to have 6 log base 6 input x minus, and now here the 3 goes down, right? Because that's the power. 3 log base 6 input 6 minus 3 log 6 base input z. So let's keep copying down. I'm going to copy the third guy first, because we have still some work to do here. So what is gonna be this term equal to? So we're gonna have minus 3. Notice that log 6, when the base is the same as the input, the answer is 1, right? We know that from the division rule that whenever you have the logarithm with the base other than 10, you're gonna have the log of the input divided by the log of the base, right? In this case, both are the same. So this is going to be equal to 1, right? But you can always memorize it. Whenever the base and the input of the log is the same, the answer is going to be 1, right? So this is going to be what? This is going to be 6 log base 6 input x minus 3 log base 6 input z minus 3 times 1, right? 3 times 1 is simply 3, right? So this is your final answer, and this is the successful expansion of the original logarithm. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this was helpful. See you in the next videos.